I'm going to speak to us on the topic, take the limits off of God. Take the limits off of God. Father, this morning in the name of Jesus, I look to you. I say thank you for this opportunity and this privilege which you has given me once again to encourage your children. I am just your mouthpiece. I'm just the voice of one crying to prepare the way and make straight paths because you are coming soon. Take over this morning. Speak through me. Use me as your instrument that your children would be encouraged in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. God is good. And when we go to God and we ask him to do things in our life, sometimes we have a way of limiting him, setting boundaries. And we try to limit God according to our own thinking and our own ability. But God cannot be limited. So this morning, I am encouraging us to take the limits off of God. And when I review and research the word limit, limit is a point or boundary which you cannot go beyond. Limit is you set a boundary and you cannot go beyond that boundary. You have to stay within that circumference. It is said when a young elephant is being trained for the circus, it is tied and restrained with a rope and its mother is nowhere in sight while the trainers contort the young animal into the position they need him to perform. Even when the restraint is removed, the young animal will not go any further because he is trained to limit circumference. And the animal being tied to a certain perimeter, the rope only allows the animal to go but so far. And because he is in that perimeter for a period of time, he's restrained. That's where his mind is set and geared. And when the trainers remove the rope or the restraint from him, he would not go beyond that point, even though he is set free. We also put limits on ourselves and limit what we can do and what we cannot do. But God cannot be limited. The God that we serve cannot be limited. So take the limit off of him. When we go to him and we request something in our prayer from him, don't let us tell him how to do it and when to do it and where to do it. God cannot be limited. God is finite, which is infinite, which means he is limitless and endless in space. He is impossible to be measured or held by boundaries. In Psalms 147 and 5, it says, God is our Lord and of great power. His understanding is infinite. This implies the concept of infinity when it said our Lord is great in power and his understanding cannot be measured. if something is beyond measure, according to the dictionary, it is infinite. God cannot be put in a space. He cannot be contained in a particular circumference. His understanding is without limits. God understands what every person is going through. He also knows the path to take to get us through every situation. There is nothing too difficult that he cannot bring you through. He has great power. He is all powerful. So we can take the limits off and allow him full range in whatever situation we are going through. He can do it. And if God can't do it, it cannot be done. But he is limitless and he can do anything. He is unlike human being. And 1 Kings 8:27, this is what Solomon said. But will God indeed dwell on earth? Let me read that again. But will God indeed dwell on earth? Behold, heaven and the highest heaven cannot contain thee. How much less this house which I have built. Think about that. When Solomon considered God, he asked the question, will God indeed dwell on earth? He thought about the heavens and the highest heavens, even the place where God sits on his throne. And he said, you cannot be contained. You are infinite. Even this house that I dwell, that I built for you, it cannot contain you. You cannot be held in a building. God's presence is with us. And he allowed, or he sent the third person in the Trinity, the Holy Spirit, to guide us through whatever we are going through. His spirit indwells the believer. And Solomon is saying, when he built the temple, God's presence indwells the temple. But we cannot put God of himself in a space. God is omnipresence. He is everywhere. He of himself created this universe. And he is outside of creation. He is in the highest heaven, the heavens of heavens. And nothing in this world can contain him. We build assemblies. We build buildings where we could gather and where we could assemble together to worship him in unity and in spirit. But these buildings that we built, as beautiful as they are, they cannot contain God. We cannot put God in a time capsule. He cannot, and he will not be confined to space or to the image that we have of him. And in our mind, because of the different pictures that we have seen, we try to make an image of God in our minds. And we think that these little images that we make in our mind of God, that is him. And we try to contain him to that. But God is measureless. He is limitless. And nothing in this world can contain him. Unlike man, who is finite and is born with limitations. And according to Webster Dictionary, the word finite means having limits or having boundaries. Man have born with certain limits and limitations. So we can only see but so far. And we put limits on what we can do. And we have this tendency to treat God the same way. But God cannot and he will not be treated like this. He cannot and will not be treated like mere man. God is higher than us. And the word said his thoughts are not like her thoughts. His thoughts are high above the heavens. We cannot comprehend God. We cannot understand him and understand his doing. And if we could have understand God, then he would not be God. Genesis 1:26 said, then God said, let us make man in our own image after our likeness. God created man in his image and in his likeness. Therefore, God is finite, is infinite, but man is finite. God created man in his image and in his likeness. Therefore, God is infinite and man is finite. Because of that, man has limitations, but God does not have any limitation. So let us take the limits off of God and give him full range of whatever we need him to do. None of us can say what will happen tomorrow. None of us can say what will happen in our lives. Because as the book of James says, you do not know what tomorrow will bring. You do not know what is your life, for you are a mist that appears for a while, for a little time, and then vanishes. Man is as the flower of the field. In the morning, we are green and flourishing, but in the evening, we are cut down and withered away. We often try to take God for granted and to set God on boundaries around him. When we ask him for something, we set the time that we want him to answer. We set the place that we want him to answer. We want to tell him how to answer. But God will not be constrained to this. He do what he will when it pleases him. God has the ability, or his ability has no limits. God's ability has no limits. He can do anything he wants to do. He can do whatever pleases him. We as human beings, we are subject to limits, but not God. Here, if we go on the highway, we see signs with speed limits, we have to follow them. We may be going out, we see danger signs, don't go beyond this point. If we go beyond this point, it could be dangerous. We see hazard signs saying, don't go beyond that point. We have limitations all around us, but these limitations does not I will not apprehend God from being who he is. So let us allow God free range of our life. Let us take the limits off and allow him to do whatever he will in our lives. Allow him to do whatever we want him to do. He tells us come to him boldly and present a request. And when we come boldly to him and present a request to him. Don't tell him how to do it. He will do it in his time. He will do it the way he wants to and how he wants to. How can we take our limits off of God? We have to surrender our plans to him. We have to ask him for his guidance and submit all our ways to him. We have to meditate in his words and let his words indwell us, build up our most spiritual life and our faith. We have to allow the word to penetrate us, our bodies, our minds, our soul, and our spirits. We have to praise him in all things. And all that we do, we have to praise him. Take the limits off of God and let him control your life in Jesus' name. Take the limits off. Father, we thank you this morning that you are not a God of limitations. You, Heavenly Father, cannot be contained in a space. So I ask you, O Heavenly Father, to help us to use the mustard seed faith that we have to take the limits off of you and to allow you free range of our life that we can be fully used by you in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.